Hello stenographers, welcome to your own channel Panda Stenographer. For better result, I suggest you practice and keep practice. Then ready for practice? Start. The plaintiff has stated that the said property, that is house number 24, is also her self-acquired property as the defendant had no income to purchase the same, and it was the plaintiff who had purchased the same through her income, full stop. No doubt it is admitted by the defendant that he was 8 years of age at the time of purchase of the property and he has no income of his own, but the plaintiff in her cross-examination while deposing PW1 admitted that house number 24 was purchased after selling the ancestral properties of the party stop. As the defendant had share in the ancestral property, so his share in the suit property cannot be set aside only on the ground that he was not having any income of his own in the year 1988, stop. It is clear from the admission of the plaintiff that house number 24 was purchased after selling ancestral property, and due to this reason, the name of the defendant is shown as a co-sharer in the said house number 24 in the sale deed Exhibit P1, stop. Further, the plaintiff admitted in her cross-examination that the house number 25 is in possession of the defendant, stop. This admission shows that the plaintiff has no possession over house number 25, even though the same is her self-acquired property, stop. The settlement deed relied upon by the defendant is not proved on the file and same is marked the same is unregistered document and cannot be considered as an admissible piece of evidence, stop, stanza. So, in view of the above discussion, this court is of the considered view that the plaintiff is joint owner of the house number 24 situated at Chandigarh, but she is entitled to the declaration to the effect that house number 25 at Chandigarh is her self-acquired property which she had purchased by way of sale deed dated 3-5-2010, stop. Further, it is clear from the above said discussion that the defendant is in possession of house number 25 and he is a co-sharer in the house number 24, stop. Therefore, plaintiff is entitled to relief of permanent injunction to the effect that the defendant is restrained from alienating the house number 25 in any manner except by due course of law, stop. Hence, issue number 1 and 2 are accordingly decided partly in favor of defendant and partly in favor of plaintiff, full stop. Para. Brief facts as per the plaintiff's version are that the plaintiff is owner in possession of the house number 24 and 25 situated at Chandigarh and defendant is son of the plaintiff, stop. The plaintiff is 70 years old widow lady and suffering from various illness, Stop. The said plots were purchased from the income of the plaintiff during her service career in the Department of Homeopathic Medical Council of Punjab. Stop. The plaintiff is having two married daughters and two sons. Stop. The defendant is younger son and is under the influence of his in-laws and is also making hue and cry. Full stop. He is bent upon to throw away the plaintiff from her self-acquired property. Stop. The defendant wants to grab the said property by dispossessing the plaintiff. Stop. The plaintiff started constructing house number 25, which was very old construction, but the defendant started showing the said house to some strangers in order to sell the same. Stop. The defendant is clearing that the said house has been transferred in his name by the Gram Panchayat. Stop. Over.